Today I'm going to show what I believe is the best value VPS option for trading Forex with algorithmic strategies. I've been using a VPS for my Algo Forex trading for many years with no issue. In fact, I have several. I'll also show a great option for getting a free VPS. So before I compare the costs of the four options I've used over the years, let me show you how you can get a free VPS for Forex trading from one of the Forex brokers that we use. If you are trading a live account with IC Markets, then you can get this free VPS. To go to get to IC Markets, I would recommend just going to our brokers page and clicking visit the website here, which I'll just do. We obviously trade IC Markets because they've got excellent spreads and they've got fast executions and institutional grade trading, so that I always use a raw account. But here we're just talking about their free VPS. So let's have a look at their free VPS option. If we go down here, we can see you get different sizes of VPSs. Obviously, brokers take their commissions on trading costs. That's the way they make money. So the more lots that are traded, the more they'll make. So you get different sizes of CPUs. So the smallest one here, 15 lots a month. It's quite a lot. And you're going to need a pretty large live account for that. So probably at least 10,000, likely more depending on your strategy. For some people, that's going to be a very good option, and for some not. But that option is there if you are trading with IC Markets and trading a suitable amount of capital. And I'll put links for that in the description. But if these requirements are too much for you, and you're planning to trade a smaller account, you may want to check out these following options. They are Forex VPS, FXVM, Dipgate, and Contable. I've tried all of these in the past, and honestly, all have been reliable. And so really, I'm looking for the best value option, as this is obviously an ongoing payment. So it's a continually recurring cost, and so it's worth getting the best value option. So let's see how they compare on this front. First of all, I'll just quickly go to the website. So we've got Forex VPS here. If we go to their plans, we can see that you've always got these options depending on the size. They often give a bit of a guide for how many platforms you can run, but mostly I guess it's computing power. So you've got 4-core CPU, 6 GB memory, you've got that much storage, and again, you're just going to have various options for different cores and RAM and storage. Again, here, and Contable, of course. And so I've put a summary here in a spreadsheet, and I've color coordinated it, so we can easily compare these costs. So I've got the four providers here, and so we can see in this one, the color coding is basically going, well, the lowest price is the better, so that's green, and the highest price is red. And for these, higher numbers is the better value, so they're green. And so we can see right down the bottom straight away, Contable is coming out as not only the lowest cost, but also the highest power. And Contable are, for this reason, the VPS server that I have been using for the longest period of time. It's the only server I use nowadays, and it's been working well for me for a long, long time. Additional things you may be considering is, what about location, latency, etc.? And I remember when I first started, I was looking, you know, I was looking for the closest server to my brokers and lowest latency possible. And I had a VPS in London and a VPS in New York. And depending on what broker I was trading with, you know, that's where it went. And that, you know, I didn't really have any clue of how important this was to my strategies. And over the years, I just kind of found out that it's not that critical for my strategies personally, and it probably isn't for most. There may be some really high trading frequency ones that capitalize on speed in that way, but most strategies aren't teed up that way. And so for me, it didn't really matter. My VPSs are just in Germany. For Contable, that's the cheapest option, although it's pretty cheap to have them anywhere around, and probably, you know, I'd have it closer to me personally, so I'm faster on my VPS rather than saving myself, you know, 50 milliseconds of latency. And that's just me personally, and that's my system. So it depends on what's important to you. But this is fine, as I say, for me, and it's easy to backtest. So let me show you that. So I've opened up MT4 here, and I've actually just downloaded a robot from our top 10 app, USD JPY M15 robot. And I'm just going to backtest it over these 6 months, right? And what I've got is I've got the delay. So you can actually backtest on every tick model based on the real tick. So it's going to download all the real ticks from the broker. $200 account, zero latency. So let's just have a look at that. Okay, so we've got a nice graph. graph there, and it's telling me that I've got a profit factor of 1.56, and you can see 63.77 net profit with a $16 drawdown. So let's trade and fix 0.01 lots, and we've made 72 trades. Let's now change that to include some latency, which can actually be emulated in the backtester. So good. As we can see, it's really made very little difference. The graph, and it is for these strategies, they're not too sensitive to that. 1.56 same profit factor, very slightly different values, but really it's not changed the strategy. These strategies come from Express Generate, and they're looking for high probability trade setup. So they're not looking to, you know, benefit by speed. They're just looking for patterns and going, this is a high probability trade, I'll take it. And over time, you know, maybe if you get a little bit of latency or slippage, you know, it works both ways. It goes both ways in your favor. You know, sometimes it might be that, you know, that tiny little bit of latency might make your entry price just slightly worse, but sometimes it might be slightly better. And through the law of averages, it really kind of just averages out typically. So, which is what we've seen here in the back test. Now, there is some major things to consider when setting up a VPS. The major thing really is this: what happens in the unlikely event of an unplanned restart for any reason? What you want your VPS to do is you want to make sure, first of all, that you have turned off all automatic updates, because you don't want it just doing some general automatic update and going, well, I'm going to restart now. So you want to make sure that that's turned off. Easy to do, really. For planned or an unplanned restart, because you want to restart them regularly, maybe every month, and you want to make sure that your VPS isn't just going to restart and wait for you to kind of log back in before it starts operating again. You want it to automatically log back into Windows after a restart without having to manually do this. So that's number two. And number three, you want to make sure that once the machine is restarted and logged in, that all your MetaTrader terminals are going to boot back up again and continue trading. Now, some of these Forex specific services, Forex VPS, and some of these slightly more expensive services, they're kind of set up to do this. So I make sure to do this manually with Contabo, so I know it's all done properly. A few other things just with Contabo, just to make clear, because I've been using them for a long time, I just know their advantages. So first of all, they're very cheap and they're no frills. Setting up a VPS, initially it's going to take an hour or something like that if it's Contabo. And you can see here, you can select the smallest one. And so this is the cheapest option, of course. The price in Contabo on the website doesn't show that you also need to pay for a Windows license. So once you've done that, that's what I've shown in the spreadsheet. You've got quite good customization for, say, storage, or you can upgrade easily. But the point I want to make here is that you can start with the smallest VPS, but as your kind of trading needs grow, maybe you're trading more terminals and everything, you can actually just upgrade and it will just port your system to a new upgraded server with more RAM and more memory and more cores, and you don't need to redo the setup. So you can keep scaling up as much as your kind of need for more powerful systems grow. So it's a great one for beginners to just start with the smallest, and as you need more terminals and stuff, you can just hit upgrade and it will do it without you having to do any work. Contabo being a basic VPS, this is actually where the large price comes from. It's generic. So the large price difference that we see in that spreadsheet for the more power is generic. So there are no frills VPS. They just have solid, reliable servers at a great price. You just need to do a little bit of initial setup for your specific needs, in this case, Forex. So let's just quickly open those tables again, and we'll see that this is for a pretty basic sized VPS. Mine's actually a bit bigger than this one, and I've got a couple of them. This is a cost that you're going to have ongoingly. So it kind of is worth trying to lock in the best value option, even if you initially have to do maybe a little bit more effort. And like I said, the price difference will actually grow. You know, if you're going to bigger VPSs and, say, even dedicated servers, as you become more and more experienced and your needs increase, then that kind of price gap is going to get even bigger. So even more worth searching at the value. Now, I know it can seem a little daunting. As I said, there's a few things to do, and where do you start to set this up initially? I've actually put a link to a discounted one-hour coaching session in the description. During this call, not only will I be able to walk anyone through the complete setup and testing of their VPS, but they'll definitely be time to also discuss where you're at in your trading, and I'll be able to help you and answer any trading questions you also have. So I'd encourage anyone, if you are getting started and want some help with that, or want to move to a more cost-effective VPS, to use that link, and I'll be happy to help you out. To further show you how uncritical, actually, that few milliseconds of latency is. For the majority of strategies, and certainly, as I said, the ones I trade, EA Studio strategies that I predominantly trade, then check out this video, where I actually send signals to my phone to place trades manually on my phone in seconds. This has made me $1,500 during a month of travel in Europe. And latency is probably likely 60 to 120 seconds at least. And so, trade safe and bye for now.